Well, I was lost in darkness, and I began to pray. Then Jesus came to me on that fateful day. He said, "Child, I know you're sorry for all that you have done. Just reach to me, for I am the one. I am the one who died on the tree. I am the one who will set you free. When I heard you cry, have mercy on me. I am the one. I am the one. When I'm down in the valley, can't see the light of day, I look to Jesus, for He is the way. He said, child, don't be discouraged, don't be afraid, for lo, I am with you. Well, once my clothes were ragged, the world looked down, and I had no hope for tomorrow, nor for eternity. Then grace came with mercy and heard this orphan. Now I've been adopted, from bondage I've been set free. Now I'm gone.
Yeah. Who wants your gum stain for tonight, hun?
Amen. While she's getting ready, anybody want to say something for the Lord? Testify. Yeah, the floor is yours if you want to brag on Jesus.
I'm glad I'm saved.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Treasure.
Blessed dear Jesus.
I have what you need, but you keep on searching. I've done all the work, but you keep on working. When you're running
Sister Amy and them to sing, but before they do, I was looking for a scripture. I can't find it. I might can find it here. I want to tell you the scripture the Lord put in my spirit that finally made me surrender my call to preach the gospel. And I wasn't on fire for the Lord the way some people may think that I was. I was in a strait. Me and my wife both was getting worldly, if, you know, looking at my maturity in the Lord to what I was back then, a lot of people would have said, Jason ain't even a Christian. But I was saved. I know I had God in my life. And but I was double-minded. I was wishy-washy. And I went to Flat Rock Church one night, and Virgil Music was in revival there. And Virgil read these scriptures that night. He said, but Daniel purposed in his heart. And that was what his text was, that he would not defile himself with the portion of the king's meat. And that was what his text. Have you purposed it in your heart? Have you purposed it? And as he preached that night, I began to see that I hadn't purposed it in my heart. I began to see that I was wishy-washy. I just was double-minded in all of my ways. And that night, Virgil brought that scripture across to me. God give him that scripture to preach to me. And it made me go to the altar. And as a man of God gave the altar call, the call, it went out. And that night he said, you need the purpose and make your mind up. Well, I want to ask you tonight. I'll finish my story. I went that night and I told God, I said, God, I'm sorry for being lazy. I'm sorry for being slothful on your work and slothful in the way that I've been living. And at that time, God wasn't dealing with me to preach. But that very night is when God, I look back at it, that's when God, when I purposed it in my heart that I was going to make heaven my home. It didn't have nothing to do with preaching. I purposed that I was going to make heaven my home. And then after that, God started dealing with me to preach. So I want to ask you tonight, have you purposed in your heart to make heaven your home? Amen. And I know it's, and I'm not saying it in light of everybody that just said amen, but really, have you really made it up in your mind? You know, the car that you drove, you didn't call me and ask me, should I get this car? You purposed it in your mind, in your heart. You wanted that car or that truck, and you went and got it. The house you live in, the land you live, whatever you got, you didn't call Matt Poor or Walter. You purposed it. You wanted it. You got it. You desired it. You took it. Have you made up your mind? Now you look around tonight. I talked to a preacher today or yesterday. He had sent me a text. A pastor, congregation, down to nothing. Can't get people to come. Brother Mike Dye texted me and said he went to revival the other night. A church that was used to having 130, 150. He said there might have been 30 there. And just discouraging times. Look around this church. Not only on Wednesday nights, on Sunday mornings, Sunday nights. What if I had to call everybody that never came to church here? Well, just look around. You get up in the morning and start trying to text everybody. Find out where everybody's at. You get up in the morning and try to find out. I'm not the man to do that. I'm not the man to do that. Amen. Amen. You've got to purpose it in your mind. Right. Amen. I worry about people. I worry about a lot of folks in the church that, amen, that you just don't see God moving in their lives. You don't see that. My point is, church, have you made it up in your mind? Amen. If the pastor don't call me, if the deacon don't visit me, amen, if they don't send me flowers, I mean, if you're in it for all of that, you may be in it for the wrong reason. I'm not taking away and saying that we ought not love and care and take care of one another. But, I mean, look around. If we had 15, maybe. But when everybody's here, we run 125, 130 in this church. When everybody here that says they belong to Antioch, and I'm not being mean tonight, I'm just saying to you, have you made it up in your mind? Have you determined? Have you purposed in your heart? I'm going to heaven no matter what. My children don't go, I've got to go. My family don't know, I've got to go. I have purposed this thing in my heart to make it. You've got to have that way. We're in the dark days and perilous times is coming, and the coldness of the church is creeping in, and people don't even realize they're getting cold. They don't even realize they're getting far away from God. They don't even realize that they're slipping away. And in their mind, they're where they was when they was on top of the mountains. Amen. I'm saying to you tonight as an encouraging way as I can, church, and then we'll let them sing tonight. You have got to purpose it. You've got to make it up in your mind. Amen. You can't depend on a preacher to baby you around. You go to church because you want to get fed. You go to church. You bought that vehicle out there. Nobody called you. Amen. Every week and find out how the vehicle was running. After you bought it, it was yours. Take it home and drive it. Amen. And that's the way this thing is with God. You've got to purpose this thing in your heart. Don't let these perilous times and these cold times, amen, get in. Now, you can't, you're lying if you're saying that it ain't happening. Amen. You need to talk to the pastors and the preachers that I talk to during the week and find out about their congregations. And then I've got to tell him the same thing is going on at Antioch, brothers. The same thing is going on at Antioch. People have not purposed it. Well, you don't know their heart. You don't know their heart. I see their heart by where the position of their body's at. For where your heart is, amen, where your treasure will be also. People ain't got no fascination with God. They've got no love for Jesus. They've got no love for the church and the Word of God. A man of God's preaching the Bible, preaching the Word of God in power. Oh, it used to draw a crowd. Now folks would rather sit home and look at their Facebook. Amen, is to go hear the man of God preach. Church, we've got to purpose this thing. Sing us one, Amy. Brother Terry, praise the Lord.
You've been in a spot that way back in the game, couldn't quite play the fight. When you can't go to God's house, I mean, it's really bad. But I mean, in other words, if you've been in our place, I mean, you would be appreciate
it. Yeah.
The house of God. You say, no, I'll never miss another service. I want to be there. I
mean, right.
It's really hurts when you can't go.
Amen. I've not been to that place yet, Brother Junior. I know time will serve me. God, I know I'll get there.
Yeah.
But I've not been there yet. But I can't imagine it.
It hurts.
Yeah.
Yeah, it does.
Amen. Yeah. Amen. Wednesday night prayer meeting, it ain't never an option for me. I don't get up and think about it and tell the family, say, wonder where if we'll go tonight or not. Sunday morning, Sunday night, it's never been. Anybody else like that? Amen.
Get to you can't go. It won't be a thought. I mean, you get off.
Amen. Well, Brother Jason, just, you know, there's been times I've had plenty of work to do. I just shut it down. I got to go to church. It'll be there tomorrow. It's carnal anyway. I know that everybody don't like it, and I can feel it coming back at me, and that makes me want to push that much more. Amen. Praise the Lord, because I'm telling you what, when you get down to death's door, everything in this world that you've went after ain't going to mount to a hill of beans. It ain't going to mount to a hill of beans, brother. I have been by that old song, I have stood by a friend while they were dying.
Yeah.
I have stood by. You ever seen anybody die? You ever stood by and seen people die?
Yeah.
I'm talking about before morphine. You ever seen them die before they was all drugged up?
Yeah.
You don't see many people now dying with they got all that. You ever seen them die with all that medicine? I have. I've seen plenty of them die. Amen. I've watched the righteous die. And see, now you don't know the difference in the righteous and the wicked with the medicine. But you used to see the difference, brothers. I've seen the difference.
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you one thing. I want to die the death of the righteous.
Yeah.
I want to die saved. I don't want my family scratching their head about daddy. I want them to know that I've been born again. That's all I want them to know. I don't care about me being a preacher, a great preacher, or a great somebody. I want my daddy was saved. My daddy loved God. My daddy prayed. My daddy walked in the ways of the Lord. I mean, the Bible said a good name is rather to be chosen than great riches. It's great riches, friend. I'm just trying to encourage you tonight. I'm not trying to down you or beat you down. I want you to, amen, to shake yourself and get strength in the Lord. We need to have revival. We need to see these seats full again. We need a community revival. We need to see God move in our families. I've got boys that's families that's lost, and if something would happen to them, I don't know what I'd do. We've got to see them saved. I've got Christy's mom and dad's lost, and people's lost, and I can't, amen, worry about everything going on in the church, and amen, trying to keep up with this and to make sure they're there and trying to keep up with that. Well, that's what I'm trying to tell you. Make it up in your mind that you're going to go and be there. Be faithful. Be held accountable. Yeah. Amen. Be held accountable. A lot of people, I'm going to tell you something. A lot of people don't join up with churches because they don't want to be held accountable. Amen. I'm telling you the truth. They don't belong to this church, and they don't belong to that church. That way they can lay in at the house on Sunday morning and sleep till 11 o'clock. Amen. It ain't funny. It's a serious thing. Brother God wants his people to be where his people are congregating at. Amen. The word of God's being preached, and faith is being put in the hearts of God's people to fight the fight of faith and endure afflictions. And amen. Put on the whole armor of God. I ain't going to preach tonight, but I love the Lord. I want to make it to heaven more than anything. I want you to make it. I want my children to make it. Amen. I've told God a million times. If I ain't told him a million, I ain't told him once. God, I've traveled these roads up and down, God. Don't let my children go to hell. I've tried to win everybody else's lost people ever was. I have. I've stayed up and drove the midnight hours by myself a many a time. And I'm not saying that for, amen, to put a road, but I said, God, just don't let my children go to hell, God. I can't imagine the thoughts of my boys and my girls of being in hell, screaming my name in hell and saying, Daddy, get me out of here. I can't imagine that. Amen. And I'm a trusting God that I'm not in this thing for a game. I'm not in it for a show. I love all of you, but I've got to make it. I've got to make heaven my eternal home. I've got to hear them words come out of his mouth. Enter in. You've been faithful over a few things, and there's times that God gives me dreams, and I've told you this dream, and when God brings it back to me and I know it's of God, I'll tell it again, and you just have to get used to it. Right. Amen. You'll just have to get used to me telling it. Amen. There's times I didn't want to go see the sick, and times I didn't want to feel like going and traveling and doing this, but the dream that God gave me, the preacher that didn't make it, he went before judgment in my dream, and he stood before God, and amen, the angels binded him and cast him into hell. And I looked up to God in my dream, and I said, God, how could this be? God spoke and said, he has not been faithful over that has been given him. Amen. And then I seen somebody that I just knew that was lost in my thinking, in my mind. Somebody that I just knew wasn't ready. And I said, God, amen. I heard the Lord say, enter thou in, thy good and thy faithful servant. I said, God, how can this be, Lord? The preacher didn't make it, and they got to go in. And I heard the Lord say the exact same words. They've been faithful over that they've been given. Oh, God, God's give you a lot. You hear what I said, Antioch House of Prayer? You ain't on some Muslim field. Amen. You ain't under an underground a church in Asia, or where they're trying just to have meeting. God has give you a lot tonight. Amen. Ride in your comfort. Push the button, set the degree to make what you, amen, to feel comfortable. We didn't have to fight nobody to get here. We got to carry our Bibles into the house of God. We didn't have to fight nobody. I went down to Florida and I preached a revival in Florida, and they had a missionary stood up right before I got up to preach at night. And that man
man, Brother Daniel, he saw his daddy beat to death. Amen. He was a missionary in foreign fields, and you know why they beat him to death? He had a sack on his back, and in that sack was King James Version Bibles, and that man was going through and distribute them. And when they felt that man, amen, for doing that, how they beat him to death. He said, I watched my daddy get beat to death for delivering this word. He said, I watched him die, and blood running out of his nose and his eyes right in front of my face. And here we are tonight. Amen. We get to walk right in the house of God. Carrying this old blessed book right here. Oh, bless his name tonight. He's good to you and I. Amen. We come in, and I'm not being hateful tonight. But brother, when we ask to testify, it's like a mouse could run up and down the aisles of the church. What's so quiet? Amen. If you're debating on to testify on whether or not you're good or not, amen, forget it. You'll never be good enough. You'll never be bad enough. If God's been good to you, and I know he has, amen, you ought to, with everything that's within you, bless his name and honor his name and give the God of heaven praise for what he's done. Sing amen. Praise the Lord. Go ahead, Brother Clyde. Hallelujah to your name. Bless you. Yeah.
Help me sing one, then you can sing one. As the world looks upon me, as I struggle along, and I do, they say I have nothing, they just can't see. But they are so wrong. In my heart, I'm rejoicing, and I wish they could see. Thank you, Lord. There's a roof up above me. I have a good place to sleep. There's food on my table, and there's shoes on my feet. You gave me your love, Lord, and a fine family. Praise the Lord! Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. There's a roof up above me. I've a good place to sleep. There's food on my table, and there's shoes on my feet. You gave me your love, Lord, and a fine family. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. Now you know I'm not wealthy, and these clothes, they're not new. I don't have much money, but Lord, I have you. And to me, that's all that matters, though the world may not see. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. He blessed us. He's blessed us. Go ahead, Sister Amy. Carson, Tori, y'all sang. I appreciate you tonight. Love you.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Help him, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Once I serve the Lord, only with my lips.
Bless his name.
Put my trust in my church membership. But then my soul has stirred, and I earnestly pray.
I love you, Lord.
Until I knew without a doubt, I say.
Amen.
Without a doubt, I'm
saved. If I ain't saved, what in the world is this? What is this?
Yeah.
Anybody want to do anything else tonight before Paul comes? Without a doubt, I'm saved. Bless you, Dana. Tell the devil. Tell the devil who you are. Thank God. Jesus, Paul the apostle said, that old evil spirit cried out and said, Paul, I know. Yeah. Amen, Jesus, I know. But who are you? You know, the devil knows his people. He knows his children, and he knows who them that belong to God. And I tell you what, he aggravates me a lot, and he troubles me. And these times, Walter, he'll make me fall, and I feel like a dog about it, and I stumble about it. But thank God when the sun goes down at night, he knows who I belong to. He knows who my Father is. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Will y'all sing that verse one more time? Amen. I don't think I've ever asked nobody to sing that much in my life. I just want to say, you know, I want you to sing it for Jason. Just without a doubt, devil. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, have your way, Holy Ghost. Now get your people liberty tonight. Yes, they have been delivered. But tonight, Lord, you will bless them. Thank God.
Amen. Go ahead. Come on,
Brother Paul. Thank you, Lord.
I heard my mother shout.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
You asked me when you get home. She lives in the church. She's sick. Call. She can't come. But the Lord in the Spirit, let me hear her shout.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I remember old Brother Tommy down there in North Carolina. Man, I could tell when his countenance changed. I knew something different happened to him.
Come on, Jason.
He looked over at me and said, I heard Marlena shouting in the spirit. All the way back up down there.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
George Creek, he was with me in Marshall, North Carolina. He said, I heard her shouting. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. 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 You obey God, Jason. I wish Jason went ahead tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's feeling good, I know.
Just obey the Lord.
Is this on?
Let me get you one. You go ahead and find this.
I'm glad to know I'm saved tonight. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I believe if we're born again, it said that it would pass all understanding tonight.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm glad to know that I'm born again tonight. Hallelujah. If I didn't know I'd born again tonight. Hallelujah. I'd be examining myself. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I'm making sure. Hallelujah. This is revival tonight. Hallelujah. Revival time. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
We're getting ready tonight. Hallelujah. That's only a portion what is going to be like tonight. Hallelujah. I feel like hallelujah because I've been feeling it for the past week, brother Walter. Hallelujah. I've been feeling this a spirit, a revival spirit. Hallelujah. Ever since Jason sent it out. Hallelujah. And I've been making preparations. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And making plans. Hallelujah. Then got everything planned lined out tonight. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
So I can be here tonight.
Yeah.
Tonight. Hallelujah. But have your Bibles. Hallelujah. I appreciate the Lord. Appreciate his goodness. Turn with us to 1 Corinthians chapter 10. Hallelujah. Tonight. Hallelujah. I understand what Brother Junior is talking about. About tonight, hallelujah. I, 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 I've been in that situation with my mom and dad, hallelujah, and I've had to miss church and hallelujah and things, and then I've been sick myself and hallelujah and I had to miss church, hallelujah. It ain't no fun staying home, not being able to go to church, but hallelujah, Brother Junior, you've got the blood applied to the door, applied to the doorpost. When he was talking about hit the thing the night the Lord was going to come by, hallelujah, when he first said the blood is applied to the doorpost. You've got the blood applied to the doorpost. Yeah. He'll pass on by tonight, hallelujah. But if you ain't got the blood applied, hallelujah, he'll take them tonight, hallelujah.
That's right. That's right.
Hallelujah. But have your Bibles, 1 Corinthians chapter 3, beginning of the first verse. Hallelujah! I appreciate the Lord. I didn't know that I'm going to be preaching tonight. Hallelujah! Jason texted me and didn't want to know if I was coming. Hallelujah! I told him yes. I'm on my way. Hallelujah! Well, I told him yes, and he said good. But the first verse, hallelujah, reads like this: Moreover, brother, I would not that he should be ignorant. How that all our fathers were under the clouds and all passed through the sea, and all were baptized unto Moses in the clouds and in the sea, and did all eat the same spiritual meat, and did all drink the same spiritual drink, for they drank of that rock. Hallelujah. Listen to this. They all drank of that same spiritual rock, for they drank that spiritual rock that followed them, and that rock was Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They drank from the same spiritual rock tonight. Hallelujah. And I'm glad. Hallelujah. I want Psalms. It talks about, hallelujah. Let me finish reading. And hallelujah. But with many of them, God was not well pleased, for they were all sown in the wilderness. And now these things were our example to the intent we should not lust after evil things as they also lusted. Neither we be he idlers as was some of them, as it is written, the people sat down to eat and drink and rose up to play. Neither let us commit a fornication as some of them committed and fell in one day 23,000. Neither let us tempt the Christ as some of them also tempted and were destroyed of serpents. Neither murmur he as some of them also murmured and was destroyed of the destroyer. And now all these things happened unto them for example, and they are written for our abomination upon whom the end of the world are come. Wherefore let him that thinketh he standeth take heed lest he fall. That's all I want to read tonight. Hallelujah. I thank you for standing for the word of God. But hallelujah. If I have put a title onto this, hallelujah, I would call it coming out of the wilderness. Hallelujah. I believe that God has brought us out of the wilderness, Brother Jason. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And brought us into his fold. Hallelujah. But hallelujah, that this world, people have turned back and got their eyes on the world. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And Jason talking about these preachers telling them that about the churches that ain't got but 25 and 30 and so members out. Hallelujah. But they've turned their eyes back on to the world. Hallelujah. And they've got their eyes on the world and got their eyes on man. They're listening to what man tells them to do, and they're murmuring and complaining. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And hallelujah. And God ain't pleased with that tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He ain't pleased with the murmuring. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In that verse 4. Hallelujah.
Brother Paul.
They're in verse 4.
Good preaching,
man. Yeah. In verse 4. And did all drink of that same spiritual drink. They drank that same spiritual drink at one time. Hallelujah. But They've turned their back from it. Hallelujah. And they ain't a drinking. Hallelujah. But hallelujah, I'm glad I'm a drinking from a fountain that'll never run dry tonight. Hallelujah. I'm glad that I'm drinking from a fountain that runs forever tonight. Hallelujah. I'm a drinking from the head of the fountain tonight. Hallelujah. And did all drink of that same spiritual drink for that. Hallelujah. For that, they drank of that spiritual rock that followed them, and that rock is Christ. Psalm of David said, lead me to the rock. Hallelujah. Which is higher than I. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I. I want to go to the rock. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That is higher than me tonight. Hallelujah. I want to go to the rock that's above every rock tonight. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. Every rock that is high, that rock is above every rock tonight.
It is.
Hallelujah.
That's good preaching, bro. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He said, upon this foundation.
Right.
Hallelujah. He is that foundation.
Yeah, he is.
Hallelujah. Build upon the rock. Hallelujah. That foundation. Hallelujah. Build upon a solid foundation.
Right.
Hallelujah. Waller, you don't go up out there and build on a house on every kind of ground out there, do you? Hallelujah. You if it's a bad ground at the top, you dig down in that earth until you can hit some solid ground. Hallelujah. Come on.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. You got to build that house on a solid foundation. Hallelujah. And when the wiles of this other devil comes at you, hallelujah. And then when this world comes at you, hallelujah, you ain't going to turn back. Hallelujah. You ain't going to lay out of church. Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord.
You ain't going to want to lay out of church.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
But this world, they took a little old plague, pandemic. Little old plague called COVID. Come on.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Heavy Lord.
Hallelujah. And they've let that turn them around.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let that cause them to stay out of church.
True.
Hallelujah. I feel safer in church with this COVID than I do out in this world tonight, Brother Walter.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, bless you.
I watched some of them bowl games over the holidays. Hallelujah. And hallelujah. And they were sitting shoulder to shoulder. Hallelujah. You couldn't get a pin down between them. Hallelujah. Without sticking one of them. Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And you don't hear anything about people like that catching COVID, do you?
Listen,
hallelujah.
Yeah.
You never hear a COVID coming out of that, do you? Hallelujah. Come on.
Listen,
come on.
Yeah,
what's wrong with the church house? Hallelujah.
One thing.
I'd rather sit shoulder to shoulder with somebody in church than I would out there. Hallelujah.
Sure.
Hallelujah. Come on. I've got my foundation upon the rock.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yeah,
hallelujah. But they've gone back out into the wilderness. Hallelujah. And that's what it says over here. Hallelujah. But many of them but God was not well pleased, for they were overthrown in the wilderness.
Yes.
Hallelujah. They went back out there. They went after they followed after their own lust. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They followed after their own lust tonight.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Went after idols.
Right.
Idols. Hallelujah. Neither be he idlers as was some of them, as it is written, people sat down to eat and drink and rose up to play.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yep.
Look at Samson, huh? He had all the power he needed. Hallelujah. But he sat down and Lila's lap.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And lost all his power. Hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah. It's easy. The devil's out there to steal your power tonight.
Yeah.
He's out there to steal your power tonight. Hallelujah. He'd give anything to have it. He'd give anything to have you what you had tonight, but he can't have it. He can't have it.
Amen.
He can't have it.
Amen, Paul.
Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world tonight. I'm glad I've got that greater one at you. That was a three Hebrew children, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Hallelujah. Told them if they didn't bow before this idol. Yeah. Hallelujah. They're going to throw them in the fire.
Bless you, Lord.
Come on. Hallelujah. They said we ain't going to bow.
No, boy.
We ain't going to bow. I ain't going to bow you tonight. I ain't going to bow tonight. Hallelujah. And they wouldn't bow. They threw them in the old king said to heat the furnace up 7 times hotter. Mm-hmm. Woo, hallelujah. And they threw them in the end of the fire. Hallelujah. Yeah. And they came, and they looked in and said, didn't we not only throw three men in?
Oh, yeah.
And they said, yeah. But he said, I see 4 men in. And all up walking around. Yeah. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
The fire can't hurt you tonight.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. The only fire I want is has a fire that come from above. Hallelujah. There's that power. Hallelujah. That power tonight. Hallelujah. That's the only fire I want tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As Brother Jesse's granddaughter sings, hallelujah, it's like fire shut up in my bones. Hallelujah. I'm glad I got that fire in my bones. Hallelujah. I'm glad I got power in my bones tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Bless him, Lord.
I don't feel the pain one right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But call me in the morning. I might tell you the difference. Hallelujah. Don't feel the pain one right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because I got fire shut up in my bones. Got fire shut up in my bones. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I believe I could drown tonight, Brother Walter. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Because I'm on that rock, ain't you?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Don't go back out on the wilderness tonight. Hallelujah. Many of them tonight.
Yeah.
Many people out on the world have gone that used to go to church have gone back out in the wilderness, Brother Jason.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I don't have a desire to go back. They ain't done back off from me. I've got a 28-year-old daughter done gone on. Hallelujah.
Yep.
Love to go to church. Every Saturday and Sunday. Dad, we're going to church. Yeah, we're going. Hallelujah. And she'd get up and sing. Hallelujah. And my other daughter back on, they'd get up and sing. Got a precious old mom and dad, brother. Gone over there.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I don't have no desire to turn back into the wilderness tonight.
Yeah.
Nothing here to pray, nothing here for me. Yeah. Hallelujah. Appreciate the Lord. Come and give us a song tonight.
That's
wonderful. I wonder if anybody here, you ain't lost and undone without God.
Hallelujah.
Or either you're thinking about turning around, going back out in the wilderness.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Don't think about that. Hallelujah. I appreciate our church tonight. I appreciate our pastor. Love our pastor and his family. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Love our church. Hallelujah.
Amen. Love them. That's right.
Hallelujah. Glad to see Brother Junior and his wife back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Miss people when they ain't here tonight.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because we know where they sit. And when they ain't sitting where they're supposed to be, hallelujah, you will miss them.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. That was an empty seat, though.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Empty place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Go ahead. If you're here and you're lost and undone.